Moo, moo, moose. Halloween, a time when the dweebs can be anything they want to be, which is pretty weird stuff considering they have no idea who they are in the first place. Yo, Barney, what's Willie doing there?
He's a scare cow, rude dog.
See what I mean?
A little more.
A little more.
Perfect. What do you think, Winston?
Regarding what, madame?
The pumpkin.
Actually, I rarely think of members of the squash family.
You're a big help.
Thank you.
Hey, so dweebs, you got your Halloween costumes figured out yet or what?
Gee, Rude Dog, we still can't decide what to be.
Hey, don't sweat it, Tweakman. There's still a few days left. Hey, we'll talk about it after I make this delivery.
Ooh, can I go, Artie? Huh?
Sure,
can I, please?
I could use the company. Yo, Winston, while I'm gone, you're in charge here, capiche?
Oh, my. It would be an honor, sir.
And dweebs, whatever Winston here says goes, okay?
All right.
There we go. Indeed, yes.
Right.
Well, let's go.
I say, it is time for the afternoon news. Hello?
Resulting in a 9-car pileup near the center of the city.
News?
Hey, Winsky, old boy, give us a break, will you? The news? Boring.
Yeah, we want to dance.
News is dumb. Turn it off.
Yuck!
Yes, need I remind you who Sir Rude Dog left in charge?
Yeah!
Who?
Mr. Big Shot here.
Wrong, Kibble. He left me in charge. And I say, the news.
And in Midtown today, an ice cream truck collided with a truckload of chocolate syrup. And both rammed into a fruit stand full of bananas, creating the world's biggest banana split.
Fascinating.
In other news...
Watch out for Scarecrow, Winston! And that!
Get free!
Watch out below!
And now back to our movie, Attack of the Green Slime Aliens.
We're expecting word any second now.
I say, must you insist upon playing with that dreadful flying Holstein while I'm watching important news?
Sorry, Winston.
Well, hey, what's the lowdown, Winstoad, and the world at large?
Yes, we now have official reports that the green slime aliens have not only attacked our city, but have been spotted landing all over the planet.
There's nothing really, except that green slime aliens are attacking the Earth. Green slime aliens are attacking the Earth!
The army is warning everyone to stay in their houses. Barricade all the doors. The aliens are everywhere. Avoid speaking to strangers.
Dad.
What are we going to do?
Yeah, what are we going to do?
I don't know.
Oh, yes, quite right. The first thing we must do is fortify the domicile.
Fortify the domahoo?
Fortify the domicile.
I don't know. What's that mean?
Never mind. Dweebs, to arms! Man your battle stations! Batten down the mustaches! Rally round the frog!
Hey, I think he means lock the doors and windows.
Come on, let's hurry!
Yeah, come on! Yeah.
Oh, boy, Rude Dog, you sure delivered that package. That was some delivery.
Hey, babe, I couldn't have done it without you.
Really, Artie? Wow, Artie, look, a Halloween store.
That's a costume shop, Tweak.
Oh, yeah, one of those.
Hey, Tweakola, what do you say we surprise the dweebs by picking up the costumes right now?
Wow, Artie, what a great idea.
Come on.
Sand here, sandbags. Sandbags here. Yes, of course. And a bunker here. Yes, quite right.
A bunk bed? Where? Wow, Wow, this is great, huh, Artie? Are you gonna get a costume, too?
Hey, I'm way ahead of you, babe. Slam your eyeballs against this getup.
Neato.
We're almost done, Winston.
There. That should keep the slimy vermin from our humble abode.
Fighting alien sure is tough work.
You could say that again, Caboose.
Okay. Fighting alien sure is
enough.
Boy, I can hardly wait to get home and show the Dweebs what we got them. Hey, maybe we should surprise them, huh, Artie?
Like wear our costumes? Sounds like a winner to me, pal.
Yeah.
Just a couple of more boards. And there. That ought to keep us in here.
Yes, well, hopefully it will keep the aliens out as well. Oh, my.
Now, Quacky, Willie, you keep watch for any of those ugly slime aliens, and I want to hear a big quack, 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 and a moo if you see one, okay? We're counting on y'all.
I feel safer already. Get. I say, Reginald, how's it going up top?
A-okay, Winston. I poured enough cornflakes on the roof to feed Omaha. Those aliens try to land up here. We'll hear them crunching a mile away.
Kudo!
Oh, this is just the greatest, Artie.
Hey, you're looking bad, Twink.
Really? Hi. Gee, I guess I am scary.
Ooh, scary and a half, Twink.
Hey, I'm here.
Fellow dweebs, according to my plan, we are now totally secure.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, quite. But just in case the slime aliens do manage to penetrate our defense, yes, I believe we should devise a booby trap. Now here is what we have to do, Reginald.
Boy, will the Dweebs be excited when they see us, or what, Artie?
Knowing the Dweebs, Tweak, excited ain't the word. Home sweet home. Ready for a little trick or treat?
Oh, yeah. Can I push the button, please, Artie? Can I?
Hey, it's all yours, you little monster.
Yeah!
Looks like we got a slight mechanical problem here, Tweak. Come on. Whoa, Tweakstar, what have we got here? Somebody do some redecorating while we were out?
Gee, Rude Dog, I don't know.
Yo, Dweebs! Open the door.
Egads! The green slime aliens have arrived.
Do you think so?
But it sounds like Rude Dog.
Hey, that's just like those slime balls. They can sound like anybody, and they can look like anybody, too. Don't open the door.
No Dweebs. This gets more interesting by the minute. Come on, Tweak, let's try the back door.
Okay.
I say, Bonnie, see anything unusual?
Yeah, a clump of dandelions, an old tire, Seymour. A couple of aliens.
Aliens?
Uh-huh. They're green and slime.
Aliens!
And they're heading for the back door.
It's a good thing Reggie nailed it shut.
Me? I thought Caboose did the back door.
Well, but I thought Barney, but well, that was his Jehovah boy.
Oh, no!
Hey, Tweak, check it out. Circus of the Dweebs.
Yeah, gee.
Excuse me up there. What is going on here?
We're just Dweebs, please.
Yo, Dweebs, it's us.
Us who?
The Tweakster and me, Rude Dog.
Oh, sure. Have you guys looked in a mirror lately?
Hey, come on, Reg. These are costumes. We wanted to surprise you.
See, it's us. Fooled you, huh?
Don't believe them, Dweebs. They're aliens. I saw this on Invasion of the Doggy Snatchers. Next, they'll be telling us they haven't attacked the planet either.
Attacked what?
See?
We saw you green slime aliens on TV.
Yes, it's true, sir.
The TV?
The world is safe once again. The green slime aliens are going home.
Whoa. Now that's a relief.
We hope you have enjoyed watching Attack of the Green Slime Aliens.
Yo, Dweebs, don't you guys know the difference between a movie and reality?
Yeah, don't you get...
Of course. The movie starts at 1 and reality's not until 3:30.
Why do I get the feeling I'm living on Planet of the Dweebs? I was almost asleep for the fifth time that night. It seemed too good to be true. Too much to ask for. Too dreamlike. It was. Get the little engine that could there under control so we could all cop 3, maybe 4 Z's.
Yeah, sure, Rude Dog.
Okay.
Okie dokie.
We shan't let it happen again.
Come on, Boogie, I'm okay. I won't meet you that day.
You think you could do it tonight?
Yeah.
Look out there, I'm gonna get that big bang, big bang, big bang, big bang here. Come on. Well, I'm just real sorry, everybody.
Satch, watch Caboose so he doesn't fall asleep while we try to figure out how to help him, okay?
I'm here with you. Okay.
What we need is a cure.
Caboose, hold your breath.
Huh? But I don't think that...
Come on, please.
Okay. Let me see.
I'm a bullshit mechanic, I'm a tell you what we
can. Huh? How long do you all suppose Caboose should hold his breath before those dreams go away?
Uh-oh. Caboose, breathe!
This is my idea. I could be wrong.
Satch, Caboose does not have the hiccups.
See? It worked. He's all better.
Yo, Dweebs. Controlling Caboose's dreams does not seem to be the ticket here.
I know. Maybe we should just keep him awake. He can't dream if he's awake, can he?
Good idea, Tweak.
Oh, yeah, he can't. I do.
Yeah,
hey. Yeah. No, you can't. Yes, you're quite right. Yes.
Yeah, but how are we gonna do that?
I have an idea. Here, Caboose. If you read to us, that'll keep you awake.
Well, okay. And so the little princess ran off into the woods. And I think I can.
Crying baby.
big old, big old, big old.
Uh-oh, he's at it again. Wake him up. Kaboom!
What? Oh, big old, sorry.
We just gotta keep him awake tonight.
Might I suggest watching him in shifts of an hour each?
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's great. I'll take the first shift.
Whoa, chill out, Caboose.
But Rudolph, there's a big old
decay! Hey, Caboose, hold the phone, babe, just a second here. Dweebs, I think it's time we show Caboose that trains can't hurt him. Kind of give him a little railroad re-education, you know what I mean?
Well, how you gonna do that, Rudolph? Big train.
Dweebs, it's traveling time.
Huh? Will you quiet down, you nincompoop? We are here to catch dogs, not audition for a Broadway musical.
Sorry. You don't like my singing.
What's this? Rob, this is our lucky day. Yes, Cupid. Rude Dog just delivered 7 dweebs to go. To the pound, that is. Yeah. Now listen up. He's I'm tasty.
Okay, dweebs, this is gonna be a breeze. A cinch, a piece of cake, no problem. Correction, 1 problem.
Trains.
You, my little petrified friend, have got some serious climbing out of the car to do.
Did you see how scared Caboose looked? How are we going to help him?
Fellas, our prayers have been answered.
Huh? Oh, boy. What'd we ask for?
One of those. Look.
Oh, boy. It's a... What is that?
Hey, it's a dweeb-powered railroad car. Come on.
I can't do it, Artie. I bumped my noggin on a train a long time ago, and ever since then I've been scared of them. Big old train, look out!
Hey, Caboose, sweetie, like you said, that was a long time ago, pal. This is different. This is today. This is...
Caboose! Yoo-hoo! Ha!
Hey, Caboose, what do you see? Look at this.
This is a nut house.
Hey, no big deal.
No problem.
Look,
chickens. Chicken,
Satch. Yeah, them too. Them dweebs is everywhere, Rot. The only way to deal with this situation is to divide and conquer.
Yeah, right and conquer. Right and conquer.
Capture them one at a time, you bozo. Let's go after the little one first.
Yeah, little one first.
Where do you think you're going?
I don't know.
That way, biscuit brain. You one of these days when I get home.
Gee, maybe we should show Caboose a caboose.
Perfect. He's all alone and ripe for the picking.
Ripe for the picking.
All we have to do is roll that car away from the rest, and then we jump him. Come on.
Atta boy. You see? Nothing to be afraid of.
Gee,
So this is a locomotive, huh?
Yes, yes, dear me. In my day, all we had was one lever and a pull chain for the whistle.
Like this?
Hey, what the heck?
Sorry!
Terribly sorry!
It's okay, no problem. Caboose? Caboose?
Hi.
Whoa. Caboose, babe, if I told you once, I told you 1,000 times. Stay out of the glove box.
Sorry.
Oh, my.
Tweaks in that caboose. We gotta tell our date. Huh? Oh, no. Help! Help! Caboose! Herman is... Tweaks in trouble.
Tweaks in trouble. Herman Rot.
Oh, Tweaks in trouble?
Caboose, you have made one serious metamorphosis today, my friend. From a scaredy cat to one courageous dweeb.
Well, I do.
You can take that to the bank, pal.
That little dweeb brain seems to be in a good mood today. Well, I'll just have to do something about that. And the one, and the two. Good morning. What kind of scared is that?
Either Tweak has finally come to his senses, or he's gone out of his mind. It occurred to me it was about time I had a little dog-to-dweeb talk with the Tweakster. Yo, little buddy, how you doing? I couldn't help but notice, is something bothering you?
What's he saying?
Something about Butter and Tweak.
So feel free, pal. You can tell old Rude Dog anything. Excuse me. Pardon me there, Willie, Mr. Cow. Don't you think it's time for you and your friends to be, moving on? Tweak! Yo, Tweak! Oh, I see. I should have guessed. Puppy love, huh? Yeah, you got all the classic symptoms. So, Tweak, what's her name?
How would I know that, Archie?
Easy. You ask.
You mean talk to her? I couldn't. She's so...
Whoa, whoa, hold the phone here. I think I'm starting to get the big picture. You never even met her before, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know where to begin. So how about I give you a couple of rude pointers?
Gee, would you, Rude Dog? Would you really?
Yellow, Rude Dog delivery. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, I see. Well, that's cutting it a little tight, Okay, you got it. Listen, Tweak, I got a super rush delivery. I gotta go. Oh, but I'll be back real soon, I promise, okay? Now, in the meantime, hey, yo, any of you Eves Dweebers know anything about girls?
I've seen them.
Well, yeah, I do.
Me too.
Me three, too.
Pardon me, but I am a girl.
As I recall, in my youth, I was considered something of an expert in the field.
See, there you go, Tweak. These guys can help you till I get back. Okay, little bro?
Okay, Root Dog.
Well, now,
and remember, Dweebs, keep it rude.
So like I was telling you, Tweak.
Hey, how come you get to go first?
ARD said to keep it rude, right?
Yes.
Well, rude rhymes with dude, and that stands for Reggie. Get it?
Boy, that's amazing, Reggie. You can be a dweeb and a jerk at the same time.
Thanks. Huh? Now, if you really want to get a girl's attention, Tweak, you gotta have attitude. Hey, style is everything. Now, which apartment did you say it was?
That one.
Great. Now get out there and show her what you're made of.
But I don't know what to say.
Tweak, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Attitude, remember?
Okay.
Lower.
Okay. Well, you see, lady. I can't do it, Reggie.
Okay, Tweak, watch and learn. Let a pro show you how this is done. Yo, babe, check me out. Whoa! See? It works every time.
Wow, that's wet.
Honest, Tweak, I know a surefire way to get a girl's attention.
Really, Barney?
Uh-huh. I used it back on the farm. First thing we gotta do is find ourselves a mud puddle.
Huh?
That one over there ought to do fine. Then you roll all around in it, kind of like, well, this here.
Like this?
That's it. Now, come on.
Boy!
Now, grab yourself a nice present. Something good, like,
some pretty flowers?
Nah, a bunch of corn cobs.
Corn cobs?
There. All set. Come on.
Are you sure this is gonna work?
Guaranteed.
Hi, Kibble. What are you two doing?
I was just showing Tweak here how I courted my girl back on the farm.
Yeah, really? What kind of girl was this, Barney?
Well, she was pretty and pink, and when I told her I loved her, she went oink, oink.
Oink? You mean she was a pig?
Uh-huh. And her name was Peggy Sue.
A pig? But I'm no good at this, Caboose.
Trust me, Blake. Girls love it.
Okay. Me.
Home on the range.
Get out of here, you lousy mutts.
Whoa!
Come on, Tweak, let's begin. Get that skedaddle. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Well, you see, it has been my observation that in romance, as well as warfare, readiness is everything.
Now then, let's rehearse.
Tweak, you are Romeo.
Uh-huh.
And Kibble, you, my dear, are Juliet.
Okay.
Are you ready, my lad? Ready, Juliet?
Ready, already.
Proceed.
Okay. But stop. What light through yonder window break? Why, it's Rude Dog in the Cadillac. Huh?
It is? What page are we on?
No, silly. Look.
Silly? What page is that on?
Hey, what's going on here?
Well, I'm Romeo, and I'm Juliet.
No kidding. And, who are you, Winston?
I am confused, sir. I don't recall a motor car in this play. No, I don't. No, motor car.
Dweebs, you gotta love them. Yo, Tweak, listen up, babe. I don't know what these dweebs have been telling you, but I'm gonna give you my secret formula for success with girls.
Huh?
Just be yourself.
That's it?
Bingo. All you gotta do is walk up and say hi. You know, just act natural.
But Audie's right.
Yeah. Come on.
But
go on.
Yeah,
you can do it. Well, okay, here I go. This is me going. Okay.
Go on, little buddy. We're right behind you.
Boy.
Hello, Dweeb brains.
Is there a problem here?
Hello, rude dog. A problem? No, Mr. Rude Dog. Sir, it's a beautiful day. Isn't that nice? Bye.
Yo, Tweaks, come on. Let's regroup here and see how Tweaks doing. Remember now, just be yourself.
Okay.
Well, hi there, cutie. Is that for me? Would you like to come in?
Me? Yeah.
Well, come on in, sugar.
He did it. I taught him everything he knows.
They're coming out.
Whoa. I've heard of ad couples before, but this is ridiculous.
Winston, Dweebs, if you ask me, the Rude Dog School of Charm has just witnessed its first graduation.
Oh, gee. How am I supposed to earn any merit badges if... Oh, right, a little old lady. A pup scout is loyal, brave, fast, and friendly. I'll help you across the street, little old lady.
Huh? Wait, but I don't...
Ah, that's no trouble.
Oh, my.
Oh, no need to thank me, little old lady. I'm earning my Helping Senior Citizens Merit Badge.
Thank you? Are you out of your little dweeby skull?
Huh?
I was waiting for that bus before you ganked me over here.
Really?
Now I've got to wait an hour for the next one.
Sorry. Another 200 pounds of these recycled pop cans, and I'll earn my Environment Pal Merit Badge.
And I can earn my Scary Stupid Pup Scout Badge.
Morning, Rude Dog.
Good morning, Tweekster. Good morning, Dweebs.
Morning, Rude Dog.
Well,
morning.
Hi,
Rude Dog.
There's one.
Got it.
So, where's our one and only Dweeb at this morning, guys?
Well, I believe young Miss Kibble has gone off in pursuit of greatness, immortality, and medallions of honor.
trying to earn her Pup Scout merit badges, Rude Dog.
No kidding. That's a kick.
Hi, Rude Dog.
Do I detect a depressed dweeb laying on a pressed dweeb here?
I'm a Pup Scout merit badge failure, Rude Dog. But you wouldn't understand.
Oh, I wouldn't, eh? Well, what would you call this, Kibble? A dish rag?
You were a Pup Scout?
Bingo. And a pretty good one at that, wouldn't you say?
Wow, look at that.
Now, what badge is causing you all the problems, kid?
All of them.
Whoa.
Well, let me put it this way. Which one can I help you with?
Gee, Rude Dog, you do that?
Hey, come on. Would a Pup Scout lie?
Camping. That's it. Help me earn my camping merit badge, Rude Dog, please.
Think about what you're saying here, Kibbo. Do you really want to take them into the woods where the wild animals live?
But the Pup Scout manual says I can earn a whole bunch of merit badges on one camping trip, Audie. I can get my animal friends merit badge, my friends and nature.
Oh, okay, right, okay.
Miserable dweebs.
All right, dweebs, listen up. A camping trip is serious business. I can see. Ready for what is the question that comes to mind.
So, the dweebs are going camping, eh?
Dweebs, we are going out to rough it in the woods, huh? Not start a Wild West clown school.
Sure. They want to rough it, huh? Well, a few well-placed holes in this tent can make it extra rough.
All packed and ready, R.D.
Yeah.
All right. Dweebs, hold.
Huh? Oh, no. I don't want to go camping. Help me out.
All right, we're here. Now, form a line and we'll get this trailer unloaded in record time.
Here you go, Kibble. Yeah. Oh, geez. The woods. Fresh air, trees, ticks, bugs. Oh, I have animals. I hate this. I gotta think of a way to make these jerks wanna go home.
I see. This reminds me of the time I was in darkest Africa.
Oh, pray tell. How was it?
I haven't a clue. It was so dark, I couldn't see a thing, Reginald.
Yeah, well, this ought to brighten up the jungle for you, Buana.
Dear me. Holy...
Whoa, hey. The chair fell apart.
That is why they call it a collapsible chair.
Oh, yeah. I forgot.
All right, listen up. According to the book here, Kibble can get her first merit badge by taking a 5-mile hike with full backpack. Let's hit the trail, dweebs.
Those boulder-filled backpacks ought to take the fun out of this hike.
Boy, I didn't think these backpacks were so heavy.
Yeah, mine feels like it's filled with rocks.
It is, stupid.
Come on, kid, Tweak. Try and keep up.
Once you get used to them.
I'll say, it's almost like they were empty.
The worms.
Listen, guys, you gotta do better than that. Your singing's gonna scare the trees.
Egad. Rude Dog is correct. Now let's take it from the top. And one, and two. Oh, much better. There you are, you see.
An attack by the very scary woods monster ought to have those dummies headed for home in no time. Wait till we see this get up. Stop that, you big moose.
Moose? A very big moose.
Hold up, Dweebs. Have a listen.
Sounds like a rumble in the bushes.
Dweebs, that is the sound of a charging bull moose. And a kitty cat calling a buzzsaw.
Huh?
Well, let's check it out. Okay, Kibble, for your animal identification merit badge, name that animal.
Oh, that's easy. It's a moose, just like you said.
But where's that thing it was fighting with?
Must have escaped.
Big horsey with antlers.
Kibble, wake up and smell the trail mix, babe. You call four when you play golf, not when you fish.
Sorry, Rude Dog. I'm just so excited about earning my fishing medal.
I'm just glad you're the only dweeb trying to earn this badge.
What you looking at, Winston?
A majestic eagle diving gracefully into the water, retrieving a fish for its supper.
Once those dweebs see the shark, they'll be headed for home on the double.
Yo, Winston, what'd that eagle grab this time?
It's an unusually large and feisty fish. Catfish, I believe.
That's Orion, and there's the Big Dipper.
Check. One more, and you earn your astronomy merit badge, Kibble.
And that's the Little Dipper. Boy, the holes in this head sure make spotting stars easy, Rude Dog.
Hey, congratulations, Pup Scout Kibble. That makes 10 merit badges. A very productive and educational camping trip, if I do say so myself. Bonnie, what are you doing?
Just talking to the local coyotes.
Sounds like you got through to one. What's he saying anyway?
Well, this guy's got himself a heck of an accent, but I think he's just yakking about, how much he likes being in the woods. Yep, that's it.
Get me out of here!
Wow, tell him to keep it down, will you, Bonnie? I mean, we got dweebs trying to sleep in here.